Oh, give me that old time evolution. Give me that old time evolution. Give me that old time evolution. It's good enough for me. It was good with the Prophet Daniel. Good for the Prophet Daniel. It was good for the Prophet Daniel. It's good enough for me. Hey, wait a minute. Yay, though I walk through the valley of the really big old-time radio medicine show, I should feel fear no evil.
Yeah.
Because three chords in the truth aren't with us tonight. And you're going to regret it if you click away. Because I'll come after you. All right, we sent the limo for you because we got to take a ride out the country road to the cornfield of dreams where the old artists come out and request their songs, and then we could leave from there when the girlies' toes get too hot and we have to leave and go out to the radio station where the studios are, and we finish the show out there. So everything's going to be really good, so you just hang on there. Just slide in the back there. Slide your little booty in the back there, and Jimmy Joe's your driver, the famous psychotherapist, and he's turning the radio on right now, taking us back to 2000s, I think.
Yeah?
Well, it's not really, that's
I
not
think
really,
you're right, yeah.
It's not really old.
It's either 2000s or late 90s.
Do you think Alan would even recognize it the way I do it?
Yes.
Okay.
You're not that special.
yeah.
You're very
special. What was I going to say? Never mind. The song speaks for itself. I don't know if it's entirely politically correct, Molly, this song, but it made it on the radio station. Hey, I noticed a song that,
yes.
Garth Brooks got on there. It's right. About a guy that crashes his truck. Mm-hmm. And kills his wife who's cheating on him and stuff.
Uh-huh.
But when he gets down to the big chorus where daddy loved something, mama loved, and the word is men,
mm-hmm.
He doesn't actually say men.
What does he say?
And I think that might have been to sneak through the
rules
and regulations.
Because
it got pretty dirty, you know.
Yeah.
Mama loved men.
Yeah.
You know, that's kind of...
very racist.
Well, I was rolling wheels and I was shifting gears just around that Jersey turnpike when Bonnie stopped me with his gun 10 minutes after midnight. He said, sir, you broke the limit here in that rusty old truck. He said, I don't know about that accent, son, just where did you come from? Hey, where I come from, cornbread and chicken, where I come from, front porch picking, where I come from, trying to make a living and working on to get to heaven, where I come from, where I come from, where I come from, where I come from. I was south of Detroit City, I pulled in this country kitchen to try the brand of a barbecue. That's it, the sign said finger licking. Well, I paid my tab and the lady asked me, she said, how'd I like my biscuit? I said, I gotta be honest with you, man, it won't like mama fixed it. Hey, where I come from, cornbread and chicken, where I come from, front porch picking, where I come from, trying to make a living and a working hard to get to heaven, I come from, where I come from, where I come from, where I come from. Well, I was chasing some down the 101 somewhere around Ventura. I lost my universal joint and I had to use my finger. Well, this tall lady, she walked up to me. She said, you got plans for dinner? I said, no thanks, ma'am. Back home we like the girls that sing soprano.
Where
where I come from. Homemade chicken, where I come from. From pork picking, where I come from. Trying to make a living and working hard to get to heaven, where I come from.
You think that was RuPaul or what?
Where I come from. Where I come from. Where I come from.
Any PR is good PR. Well, I was heading home on 65 somewhere around Kentucky. Bobtail rig with his CB on, and he was rolling on like thunder. Well, I answered him, and he asked me, he said, "Are you from out in Tulsa?" I said, "No, but you might have seen me there. I just dropped a load of salsa."
Where I come from, homebred and chicken, where I come from, front porch picking, where I come from. Trying to make a living and working hard to get to heaven, I come from. Where I come from. Where I come from. Where I come from.
Give me that old time evolution. It's, I was going to say it's synthetic with spirituality.
Yes.
It's synchronistic is the word, Ma. It's not synthetic.
Yeah.
It's synchronistic. It's a harmony. It's a wonderful, wonderful thing. And I'm not going to say another word about it. Oh, did you hear about Dolly Parton? Hey.
What about her?
We got to get going.
I've heard of her.
No, but the biggest and huge. It's huge all over. She started a new company. I think she sold her, her Wonderland thing.
Uh-huh.
This is called Doggy Parton, and it's clothes for Dolly clothes and stuff, wigs and everything, and it's going rank. It's going rank, and they're considering Dolly Parton for cats. Parton, Dolly Parton, and Doggy Parton.
Yeah.
And by the way, you know your religion?
Lord of the Rings.
Lord of the Rings?
Yeah.
Well, you know about what they just did, eh?
Yeah. What did they just do?
They just made the most expensive thing that was ever been made in the world. It was $1 billion.
Wow.
It's called Power.
Rings of Power.
Amazon.
Yeah.
Rings of Power.
Yeah. Really? That was the most expensive thing that was ever made?
And I think they're talking about made for
TV.
What? Yeah, you got to look. No, but they don't spend $1 billion.
They don't
spend $1 billion. Oh, yeah. Whatever. Okay. Get inflation. Oh, all right. Shut the doors. Lock everybody in. Get in the car. We got to get going.
Okay.
Were we already going?
No, we're going to take a ride now, Dad. We're going to move our capos down. You want to move yours down? Right down there.
You sound like the picture of health. I try to tell everybody that we're like the medicine show. We're for health and everything else. And you sound like you're going to grope.
Yeah, but then in the next show, I'll sound perfect. So the medicine will have worked.
Croak like this.
Ribbit.
Ribbit.
Oh, yeah, you do it.
Ribbit. Ribbit.
Wow. Okay. Okay. What is it now?
The ride.
Oh, the ride. Okay.
We're gonna take a ride.
We're taking a ride right now. I just want to make sure.
Take a ride.
Up past the honky-tonk.
Past the honky-tonk.
And past the county line.
Past the county line.
Through the amber waves of green.
Through those waves of green.
And past the dairy cow.
With their big brown eyes.
To the old cornfield of dreams.
Cornfield, cornfield of dreams.
And these apparitions only mom can see.
Cornfield of dreams. Cornfield of dreams.
Who's coming out tonight, Mom?
It's Merle Haggard, Dad. He wants Sing Me Back Home.
Is he sneaking out in a piano box?
Yeah.
He snuck out of San Quentin in a piano box. Right, Merle?
Yeah. Say Merle or Mom?
I said Merle. I can't see him, but I can yell at him. What'd you say? Silver Wings?
No. Sing Me Back. It says it's in a G sharp.
Oh. Whatever. Yeah. Okay. Here we go. This is a Merle Haggard tune. What else you got to say about it? It's Dead Man Walking.
Dead Man Walking.
Merle got out before it got to this point.
Yeah.
I'm very familiar with it though, you know, from my time on death row there.
You're still on death row.
Warden, led a prisoner down the hallway to his dome. I stood up to say goodbye like over it. And I heard him tell the warden just before he reached my cell, let my guitar play and friend to my request. Let him sing me back home the songs I used to hear. Make my own memories come alive. Take me away, turn back the year. Sing me back home before I die.
Sing me back home before I die.
I recall last Sunday morning, a choir from off the street came in to sing a few old gospel songs. And I heard him ask the singer, there's a song my mama sang, could you do it once before you move along? Won't you sing me back home the songs I used to hear? Make my old memory come alive. Take me away, turn back the year. Sing me back home before I die. Sing me back home before I die. It's good to hear some old country once in a while, Ma. You know, I was thinking about they should call a new country Broadway Bubblegum and some country music. Don't you think?
Yeah. I think
try
so.
To be honest.
Yeah.
But, you know, you don't want to blow it for all the kids that think they're country fans.
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
It's new country.
Okay.
It's new
country. New country.
Do you want to finish taking the ride, or do you want to say something?
I'm looking. I'm hiring. Listen to this. This is me making notes to myself. Should I read it out?
Yeah.
I need someone who can comprehend my discoveries and the therapy derived from them. And the accompanying TV, radio, web series, and podcast that you're watching right now, Three Chords of the Truth. What does that say now at the end? I can never read it then. So they can participate in the marketing and promotion.
There you go.
Intelligently. And you don't understand it. How can you sell something you don't understand? The last guy flew the coop. Never hear from him again. It's so weird to me.
Very weird.
I think it got too heavy and he went, oh, this guy's wacko. No, I don't think that at all. I think there's something weird. The last guy that it happened to said he had a heart attack. So, I don't know. But he come back a few months later and he was okay, so I don't know,
man. Dad.
Yes? We got to get over.
Everybody get back in the limo and get on the old country road, that old county line road.
Don't you speak, because you sound like Johnny Cash.
Okay.
And you're not supposed to sound. Well, I met her accidentally, St. Paul, Minnesota.
No, you can do it. I was scratching my chin.
Well, I met her accidentally in St. Paul, Minnesota.
Tore me up every time
I heard that draw, heard the southern draw. Oh, you took my dream back downstream, Cabotin, Davenport. And then I followed you, big rhythm, big river, when you call.
Followed you, big river, when you call.
Well, don't you batten down my Baton Rouge, River Queen, roll on. Take that woman on down, down to New Orleans, down to New Orleans. Oh, go on, I've been up, dumped my booze way down in the cup. I think that she loves you, big river, on me.
She loves you, big river, more than me.
I said that she loves you, big river, more than me. We don't have time to put the whole song in, so.
No. Okay. The girlies' toes, Dad. The girlies' toes.
Oh. Because they're really hot now. Because all the girlies' toes. Hanging out a window. Somebody sees a great big tower, 50,000 watts, radio tower.
GHRT.
Yep. Station GHRT.
Station GHRT.
There for you and me.
There for you and me.
Brought to you by Alice's Restaurant.
You
General
can get everything
store.
You
if
want.
You want down
at Alice's Restaurant. Down at Alice's Restaurant.
Gonna pull in the station there, go up to the front desk and see Betty Page in her cigarette girl uniform. Give you a special tea with the ayahuasca and whatnot in it.
Whatnot?
It's all natural, medicinal ingredients. Send you downstairs here to the Psychedelic Prairie Home Companion. Now listen, it's the really big old time radio medicine show, Three Chords and the Truth, starring Molly Griffin. And her old dog, Dick.
And the Reverend Dr. Joe G2 coming to you live from Station GHRT in the virtual haystack in your mind, where the show starts in 5 minutes and we don't spin the tunes on the turntable, we spin them on our souls. So kick back, chill out, and relax to the mellow sounds of the singing DJs. DJs, 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 DJs.
Sometimes we spin about our souls. Mr. Sandman.
Yes.
Publishing the science of the meaning of life and the secret to health and happiness. What a time. I think that related to that hiring page that I was making notes on. Yay! Oh, I already did that, didn't I? It was pretty cool, though, don't you think?
Yes.
Yay, though I walked through the valley of the really big old-time radio medicine show.
I liked it a lot.
I shall fear no evil because why? What was it?
Because you're a turkey.
Because I have three chords in the truth.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Yes.
Okay. All right. Well, now what are we going to do, Ma?
We're going to sing All That Glitters Is Not Gold.
Oh, golly. Here goes. Okay.
In a B. What are you doing?
Dan Seals, right? Oh, no, it's the other guy.
In a B. In a B. In a B.
Oh. Is it Dan Seals?
I think so. Isn't that what you said?
Michael Martin Murphy?
No.
Dan Seals.
Dan Seals.
Yeah, it's a little bit it's a little bit radio-like.
Yeah.
For Michael.
Yeah, Michael Martin Murphy's more, you know.
Which one is alive? Murphy. Michael Martin?
Michael Martin, I think.
Still alive?
I think so.
Dan's gone.
Dan's gone. Sealed the deal.
I know what happened to him. He got so damn sad singing this song. He just said to hell with it. I'm out of here. I saw your picture on a poster on a cafe in Phoenix. You're still the sweetheart of the rodeo. I thought you had that down pat.
I had it.
As for me and little Casey, we still make the circuit in a one-horse trailer and a mobile home. Birthday came and you never even called. Oh, I guess we never crossed your mind at all. Oh, sometimes I think about you and the way you used to ride with your rhinestones and your sequins and the sunlight on your hair. And oh, the crowd, they always loved you. As for me, I come to know everything glitter is not gold. Oh, no. Everything that glitters is not gold.
Everything that glitters is not gold.
Oh, Eddie's getting older, and last Saturday he stumbled. Oh, you know I just can't bear to let him go. Casey, she's getting older, and she started asking questions. And there's certain things a man just doesn't know.
That's perfect there. Yeah.
She still asks about you all the time, and I guess we never even crossed your mind. But oh, sometimes I think about you and the way you used to ride it with your rhinestones and your sequins and the sunlight on your hair. And oh, the crowd, they always loved you. As for me, I come to know everything that glitters is not gold. Oh, no. Everything that glitters is not gold. Everybody knew you'd make it big someday, and I guess that we were only in your way. But oh, sometimes I think about you and the way you used to ride in your rhinestones and your sequins and the sunlight on your hair. And oh, the crowd, they always loved you. As for me, I come to know everything that glitters is not gold. Oh, no, everything that glitters is not gold. Everything that glitters is not gold. No, no.
I
don't know. You do? I didn't like it so much. I thought it changed the feel. That's the beauty of this. You get to see everything from behind the stage and underneath the stage.
Yep.
Call the
the hazmat suit.
She sounds like she's ready to go. Okay. Did you hear about the new? Oh yeah.
Yeah.
You hear about the new parlor game?
What is
it's called? Where did that come from? So they ask questions like, what is the emotional theme of your character? And then everybody screams, where did that come from?
Yeah.
And then you got to do the analysis.
Yes.
And get it. And you just end up singing that old song, you know?
What one?
Give me that old time evolution. Give me old time evolution. Give me that old time evolution. It's good enough for me.
Yep.
All right, you got something funny?
No.
Oh, God. Have I got through everything here? Okay, well, what do we got for songs then? Oh, wait a minute. Should I just say the impetus of human motivation is to evolve?
Yes.
And survival and procreation, which is what everybody's doing. That's why sex and food are so big.
Yeah.
Survival and procreation are integral prerequisites of that evolution process. Because you got to look at it from Mother Nature's point of view. She's not going to leave it up to you. She's going to make sure you procreate and get another chance to evolve, because you probably won't do very good, but your offspring might do really good, and whatever, it all works out.
Yeah. They might do a little bit better than you did.
Okay, that's the last thing I'll ever say about it. Give me that old tablet. Got a song?
In Color. But it's in an A, Dad.
A blue A or green? Yeah, you said in color, right?
Yeah. I get it.
I'm not old enough to have any black and white pictures of myself, am I? Wait a minute. Hold on, just a second. Okay, we better hold on, because you're going to get your rhythm going. Hey, Grandpa, what's that picture here? It's all black and white. Ain't real clear, is that you there? Yep, I was 11. Times were tough back in 35. That's me and your Uncle Joe just trying to survive a cotton farm in a Great Depression. And it looked like we were scared dead, just a couple of kids just trying to save each other. You should have seen it in color.
Should have seen it in color.
All this one here's taking overseas in the middle of hell, 1943. The winter time, you can almost see my breath. There's my old tail gunner, Johnny McGee. He was a high school teacher down in New Orleans, and he had my back right to the day we left. And if it looked like we were scared to death, just a couple of kids trying to save each other. Should have seen it in color.
Should have seen it in color. Should have seen it in color.
All this one here is my favorite one. It's me and your grandma in the summer sun, all dressed up, day we said our vows. And you can't tell it here, but it was hot that June, and those roses are red, and her eyes are blue, and just look at that smile. Oh, I was so proud. And if it looked like we were scared to death, just a couple of kids just trying to save each other. Should have seen it in color.
Should have seen it in color.
That's the story of my life. All dressed up in black and white. Oh, it looked like we were scared
death, just a couple of kids just trying to save each other. You should have seen it in color.
Should have seen it in color. Should have seen it in color.
You should have seen it in color. Hidey-ho, your knife will never be the same.
Your knife?
Your life. I said life. You got the crap in your ears, too. Is that where your cold is? In your ears?
It's in your heart.
Okay. A what? You mean like a, you know, a whore's heart? A whore's heart. Colder than a whore's heart. Hey, wait a minute. What was I saying? You knocked me off my game here. Your life will never be the same because now you know the meaning of life and you're a bunch of shit that'll make you healthy. Because that's what we're all about, a really big old-time radio medicine show. Three chords and the truth. So, because it is, because when you got your health, you got just about everything. So, you pea-picking hillbillies, that's us. Good evening.